Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we wanted to do kind of a showcase video on one of our 16 by 24 jaw crusher modules. And we have four different samples here we're going to crush. These are probably the four most common things we're asked about to crush with our crushers. So I'm going to walk you through these and then we'll take a look at our module. The first one that we get asked about all the time is broken up concrete. Guys rip these out as sidewalks and driveways. They make huge piles in their yard and they want to recycle it, crush it up for reuse and road base and gravel and that kind of stuff. We have a bunch of concrete. We're going to do two different sizes. Right now the jaws are set at about 2.5 or 3 inch minus, so we're going to crush the first sample of concrete at that size. Then we're going to restrict the jaws down to about 1.5 inches or 1 inch for the rest of the sample, so you can see the two different sizes the jaw crusher can produce. The next thing we get asked about all the time is bricks, pavers, cinder blocks, other demolition debris other than concrete. So you can see there's bricks, some pavers in here, there's actually pieces of concrete, there's some cinder blocks at the bottom. So we're going to crush that up and show you what comes out from that sample. This is another one people ask us about all the time, river rock or field stone or rounded stone. A lot of people either want to crush it up for gravel, quarries call us all the time asking about river rock. The difference between river rock and blast rock is the blast rock is actually pretty easy to crush. It's angular, it's already been blasted and shocked. The river rock is really, really hard to crush. It's been rolled and all the angles have been taken off, so it's the hardest stones left in the river. So it's quite a bit harder to crush than just your standard blast rock. So we'll show you how that one runs. And then the last one is asphalt. We get a lot of guys that tear up parking lots, roadways. They have huge piles of asphalt they want to crush and repurpose. So we'll crush up our asphalt at that about inch and a quarter minus and show you what that looks like. So let's go take a look at the jaw crusher module and then we'll get crushing these things. So this is our 16 by 24 jaw crusher module. This is what we're going to be crushing our samples through. So I wanted to give you a quick walkthrough about it. Starts up here with the hopper. This is an 8 foot wide hopper, so it'll take a full bucket off a loader. The material goes in there, it vibrates down into the jaw crusher. This is a 16 by 24 jaw crusher. Crushes and will discharge down onto the stacking conveyor, and we'll go out and we'll catch it in a tote with the door open when we start running. The jaw crusher can do between 15 and 60 tons an hour, depending on the size of the discharge, and it's powered with a 40 horse electric motor. So let's get this thing fired up and we'll start crushing some rock. So here's the results from our four samples through the jaw crusher module. And everything crushed great. We ran all these samples at about 1 or 1.5 inch minus. We'll start here with the rocks. These ran really well. They were really hard. You could hear them crushing in the jaw crusher. They're quite a bit louder than everything else. Then we have the concrete. That crushed beautifully down to about 1 inch minus. And then it's the bricks and the demo debris next. And last was the asphalt. And I'm really happy with all four of these products. I think they went perfect through the jaw crusher, fed real nice down through the hopper and out the discharge conveyor. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please email or call with any questions you guys have, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.